Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynut and welcome back to The Witcher 3 on the Dead March difficulty. It is time. We are going to end this today. Battle preparations are complete and we're gonna go into the final battle against the Wild Hunt. I'm not gonna do any more side quests for now. I will do them of course, but that will be after this episode. And the only thing left for us to do is talk to Avalok and let him know everything's ready to lure the Naglfar into the Skellige Bay. Everything is ready, we've made our preparations, we have the Sunstone, we have 5 sorceresses. And Yennefer is questioning Avalok about his laboratory, so let's hear them out.
I've hidden nothing that could be useful in our struggle against her. As regards the you're all aware the city is exceptional. I am alone in the unknown to what it's like.
Or maybe you're just obsessed with
it. I'm obsessed.
That was a burn.
Yes, Geralt?
We are ready. We can go to Unvik.
We found the Sunstone. Gelban's gift to Dillion of the White Flea. As legend has it, she never used the stone and Gelban died of sorrow.
Won't keep Eridan waiting that long.
It seems we've everything. We can go. Keep in mind, once we commit, there'll be no returning.
We know that, and even if anything should prohibit me from doing anything else, I still have a save file from before we start battle preparations. So we have taken care of everything, and we're ready.
I'm ready.
So strap in, guys. This is gonna be one hell of an episode.
In that case, let's go.
Battle preparations completed. And we sail out to Unvik, where we battle the Ice Giant.
You will position yourselves on the cliffs. Here, here, and...
Thank you. I believe we know how to form a circle.
Okay.
Even those of us who lack eyes for the moment.
I simply wish to avoid... Oh, Geralt. We were waiting for you.
So, the fight we're gonna do is, of course, against a lot more formidable opponent than a simple ice giant. Well, really, looks like you started without me.
Really? Seems to me you'd started already.
We were discussing questions of a magic nature. Nothing of great interest to you.
Okay.
Because right, I'm just a simple witcher.
Don't worry. Simplicity has a charm all its own.
Thanks, Yennefer. But hey, let's go over the plan.
You were about to explain your plan?
It's simple. Which does not mean it will be easy to execute. I shall activate the Sunstone. If Caranthia answers the call, the Naglfar should appear in the bay shortly afterwards.
The Lodge must then prevent the ship from returning to the world of the NL, while the Imperial fleet blocks its escape by sea. The 7th Imlet's Infantry Regiment under Duke Varatra must then board it. With your help, naturally.
Okay, so we're gonna help General Varatra to... Oh no, that's Duke Varatra, right? The father of Rosa and the other one. I don't know what her name was. Emperor is not stingy, or... Well, yeah, what are you going to do, Avalok?
What about you? Where will you be?
Waiting in reserve. If something goes wrong, I shall react.
Like a general commanding troops from a hilltop? Gonna signal us by horn or use messengers?
Exquisite irony, but what did I do to deserve it? Have I given you cause to doubt my intentions?
Ladies and gentlemen, less talk, more action, please. Sisters, we must scale the cliffs.
Okay. Have fun up there, ladies.
Good luck.
Thanks. Triss. Don't know why Yennefer didn't say that, but...
Plan's missing one important element.
I guess she's confident in our abilities.
Cyril will wait. At a safe distance from the Noggle.
Ooh, she won't be happy with that. And she isn't, clearly. Guessing this wasn't Ciri's idea.
Wild guess. Not what you had in mind.
No. I wanted to go with you. That was my idea.
But I won't allow it. Far too great a risk.
Okay. Got no right to give her orders, though.
Don't have the right to order her around.
Amusing. Jirel said the same thing, only at much higher volume.
Yeah, probably.
I do, in fact, have this right. For only I know how to activate the Sunstone, which I shall do on my terms or not at all.
Okay, then.
Jirel recognized the strength of my argument. I have no doubt you'll do the same.
Yeah, I guess we don't really have a choice in that matter, then.
Do you swear to stay on shore?
Do I have a choice?
No. God damn it. She could be able to help, of course.
For a walk. Or is that not allowed either? Because I could break my leg.
Ooh. Come on, Ciri, calm down.
Oh yes. The Elder Blood can be fiery.
Yes, indeed. That soldier even got bumped out of the way. Forbidding Ciri from doing things is pointless. Got that personality from her father, probably.
From her father.
I beg to differ. Emir is a pragmatist. Ciri an idealist.
An idealist? What are you talking about?
Never mind.
No, I do want to talk about it.
If you wish to do something, brew your substances or whatnot, do it now. You won't get the chance later. I shall await you by the boats, amongst the soldiers.
I think we're pretty much done. I'm gonna take a quick look as to what the Wild Hunt is weak to, but listening to the music, I think Yennefer is approaching. Yeah, there she is.
Yen, why are you here?
Why do you think, dummy?
Something happened?
Not yet, but it might soon. We may not survive this. In fact, our chances are slim.
Okay, then. Don't worry, it'll be all right. That's comforter.
We've come a long way, and I'll be damned if we've come to fail. It'll be all right.
I admire your optimism. Wish I shared it. Listen to me. Once it's over, if we survive, I wish to leave, go far away, and I'd like you to come with me.
Of course we will.
Wherever. To Povis, beyond the Dragon Mountains, Zeracania even. As far as possible from politics, plots, and so-called high society.
Sounds like a plan. Sounds too beautiful. You dropping politics. Of course we'll go. We wouldn't leave her behind now, would we?
I'd go anywhere with you.
The answer I was hoping for. Go, Geralt. Avalaka waits.
See you soon, Yennefer.
Don't get killed, Witcher.
We won't. Well, hopefully. Might happen a few times. Because I'm a bit afraid of the boss battles we're gonna be having here, because we're still on that march. Okay, talk to Avalok once you're ready to fight. I'm gonna take a quick look around. I think there's a few services available here. I already checked out my alchemy, so every potion I could still brew, I can. Right, now I have already brew, so there's a blacksmith over there. So there might be... Is there a grindstone here? It doesn't look like it. I don't think I need anything from this man. I'll check him really quickly, but...
Are you here to spot?
I don't think there is anything for me in his inventory. And I sold my excess weight, so no. He doesn't have anything I need. So, with that done, see you.
So long.
I meditated before I started recording as well, so that's also done. Maybe quickly check what the Wild Hunt is vulnerable for. I think it's Draconid Oil, but... Can't really find it, but I think it's Draconid Oil, if I remember correctly. So, let's tell Avalok we're ready.
Barbarians.
So, Geralt. Ready?
Yes, we are. Everybody ready? Here we go.
Let's get these bastards.
With pleasure, Geralt. With pleasure.
He was enthusiastic all of a sudden. So again, pre-rendered cutscene, I think, so if you see any other costumes than you're used to by now, That's the reason. So, the Sunstone. Do perform your magic, Avalok. So there we go. Look, Ciri has her standard outfit again. With the fur collar, but...
What kind of spell is that?
It's an old love letter. Ancient. As I said, this stone was to reunite a pair of lovers.
Never thought I'd say anything of the sort to Eridin. Enverilith Sirenard. Ada Eich Blaine. Ida May.
Okay. That sounded ominous. She's gonna give him his heart, but she's gonna take his head. Great! Sounds like a plan. Here we go, ladies.
The elven bauble worked.
This is it.
They approach.
Yeah, they can't resist that call, probably. Look at that. The ocean's freezing over. I hope five sorceresses is enough to keep the white frosts, well, literally at the bay. And hopefully we're strong enough to defeat, well, pretty much the entire Wild Hunt. Oh god. Break a sword. Hopefully not, because I haven't brought a spear. Charge! Alongside Nilfgaardian soldiers. Look at that. Never thought we'd see the day. I think this ice is going to reach us first. Yeah, there we go. And that stopped the boat. Okay. Action pose.
Follow me. The Noggle Fair must be nearby.
I think he's shitting his pants. Yeah, that's really nearby. I don't think you could have missed that even from that distance. And there it is. And there's Garant here. The Wild Hunt's Master Mage. Did that do anything?
Silence. It's completely still.
It's a trap. We must flee now.
Not
it's a
time.
Trap.
Note, Sirel. You are not ready. You do not control your powers.
I'll manage.
Silly.
Get out of my way.
Silly. The ice. It's a spell. You must find the mage who cast it. Destroy his staff.
So Ciri's job is to kill Garant here now. Or at least disable him.
I'll not stop with his staff.
Thanks, Avalok, for giving her a chance. Okay, that looks pretty bad. There's Ciri. I'm gonna take control of her again. Shouldn't be too hard to work our way through those soldiers. Whoop. Wow. I don't think she cares anymore. Even on this difficulty, we just cut through everything. God, I'm gonna kill you all. Ooh, there's a lot of those. Holy shit, she's on crack. This is fucking amazing. Holy shit! And she doesn't even take a lot of damage either. Holy shit! This is awesome. Hello, Garant here. Let's kick his ass. Whew. Of course, he can teleport as well. I think I hit him. God damn it. This is a teleport match. I don't know what you guys think, but that was fucking awesome. I don't think you can follow. Kick his ass, Siri. I don't think you want to piss her off right now. I think that destroyed the staff. There it goes. Portal to that lets the white frost in is destroyed. As well as his staff. Ooh, Siri took a beating from that. And Karantir is already on his feet again.
Almost, Sira.
Nope. Oh, we were frozen. So that's why it was a trap. They didn't even show that Geralt was frozen. Hello, Geralt dear. Let's take care of you.
So be it. Let us end this.
I would have preferred Siri to handle this, but okay then. Kill Karantir. Holy shit. Orbs. Holy shit. Holy shit. Yep. That happened. I hit him, but... What the?
It's not so simple. I know where I came from.
I think I hit him. There goes his armor. Oh shit, nice elemental. Holy shit, another ice elemental. Where is he? shit. Oh, he killed his own dude. Oh shit. I think the sound is fucking up. Sorry for that. It's the game itself, it's not me. Oh, there's an elemental stuck in the sword. In the ship, I mean. Okay. That kind of fixed it, I think. Or not. I don't even know what's going on anymore. Okay, so that was kind of a bug. Sorry for that. The sound completely went haywire and the frame rate went kaput as well. I think that was a sword to the chest. Goodbye, Corantir. Uh-oh. He just teleported us. Underwater. So you know what they say, the only way is up, as Corantir is dead. And I think I need to swim up immediately right now, once I get control again. Swim to the surface. I'm swimming to the surface. Keep going, Geralt. Jesus Christ. I'm not gonna touch anything. I'm just gonna swim to the surface. Hopefully we're on time. Okay. So in a last-ditch effort, Corantir just teleported us underneath the ice to try and kill us, but that didn't work. So that's one boss fight done. And the Naugafar is trying to get out. And there's Ciri. Hopefully we're... Oh! I think those are Skelligers. Run away, Ciri! Run away! Or that. Do that. That's also an option. So she's safe for now. But now we still need to kill a commander now, don't we? The Naugafar is on fire even, look at that. Okay. So back in the hands of Geralt. Well, it saves automatically, but I don't know. There we go, saved manually as well. Because now we need to go into a war zone.
Have you seen Ciri?
So that's Udelric, the guy we saved from being possessed by the him. We're gonna try and board the Naugafar so we can finally kill off Eredin. Oh shit. Okay, they're just gonna keep spawning. I also see that I've leveled up somehow. So let's quickly upgrade the muscle memory over here. Oh, I can't even upgrade during combat. Never mind. So let's try and get out. Because these guys are also fighting a Wild Hunt warrior. There he goes, and there's Hjalmar.
Hjalmar, you seen Ciri?
By the Naugafar!
Okay.
We'll drown all you bastards till the bay is black with your corpses!
Which ones? Who are we to shoot us?
Who are we to shoot? Well, don't shoot the Nilfgaardians for now. Maybe help this guy out. Because we can kill the soldiers really quickly, apparently. Okay, they should take care of the hounds themselves, because the hounds have a lot larger hell pool. Uh-oh. That's Krach. Don't die on us now, Krach. Because taking on Eridan on your own was probably not such a good idea. Get out, Krach. Get out while you can. Come on, man.
Danny lost words.
Set the trap. Fight.
Come on, Geralt, hurry up.
You had your chance.
Hurry up. Get on with it. Farewell, Krach. Yeah, wipe that blood off your face, Mask.
I was hoping you'd come.
Because?
I've something to tell you. But I'll do so afterwards.
Here we go, people.
As you expire.
The final bout. Oh, God. So he's pretty much immune to parries. Well, you can't parry him, but don't forget to use heavy attacks. And the ice armor we can take off by using Igni. Because he gets that back every time he teleports. So if we can, Igni followed by a heavy attack seems to work. There we go. Just take it easy, take it easy. I think my Quent sign worked out. Because we don't want to get hit by that. Okay. There we go. Okay, so this is where the real fight begins. Because this is gonna suck. Holy shit, balls! Use his magic attacks against them if you can, because they somehow that still followed me. There we go. So if you can't follow up Igni with a heavy strike, that's always handy. God damn it, he got me. But if we keep Quan up, that shouldn't be a problem. God damn it. Ooh, gold. Where is he? Yeah. gonna have to fight this bit by bit. Okay. So that's the shockwaves. The shockwaves you need to get really close, because otherwise the third one you're not gonna be able to connect, as they say. If you see openings, use them, but don't get too greedy. Oh god, okay, that was the entire shield. Whew. There we go.
Silver.
We're getting closer and closer and closer. He's teleporting erratically. We're at his last third, so that's great. I think that took away my shield. Okay, come closer, come closer. Well, kind of asked for that, didn't I? Woo! You squan! You squan. Okay. Oh fuck. Never mind. Not okay. Not okay. There we go. Another hit. So bit by bit we're gonna take him down. That was most of my shield, so let's reapply it. It's really handy that I can now at least see how much my shield is left. Okay. Still nothing? Okay. Because we're gonna be heading into the final phase pretty soon now. I think that's it. Run through the portal! There we go! Because he tried to leave us there. Oh god. Don't want to die now. God damn it. He's really aggressive right now. My turn. There we go. I think we did it. There we go. In the face. Straight in the eyeball. It's over, Aridin. You have lost. Take it with a bit of grace. No, you won't. I think you wanted to tell us something, but you were going to do that afterwards. So go ahead, I suppose. Cause you're gonna die.
You said you had something to tell me.
Avalar has tricked us both.
Wait, what?
He set us against each other, and he's made off with Cirilla.
Okay.
I don't believe you.
And, well, he's dead. Don't think he had much of a reason to lie at that point. What now? Is the Nalgalfar sinking? Or was that something else? Okay, that's not good. Okay, thanks, Yennefer. We did it! We killed Aridin!
What?
That was awesome.
You knew.
All I know is Avalok might have betrayed us.
What the? That a storm?
And
look!
Looks like something else, because there's clear skies right now. I think we know where Avalok is. And that doesn't look good.
What the hell's happening?
I find it damned hard to believe, but the gate between the worlds is open.
Oh, there we go again. So if you remember, the conjunction of the spheres was what caused magic to appear and what caused monsters to appear.
What are we gonna find there?
If the tomes are to be believed, nature's laws will cease to hold. Gravity and time, Hundvik, all of it will be turned on its head.
Okay. I don't think she is.
The conjunction of spheres has begun. The worlds, they're aligned, permeate one another. Avalok could use this. Bring the NL here, or something fabulous.
So, well, at least we know where Ciri is, that's right, but let's take out Avalok.
At least we know where to look for Ciri.
Follow me, and stay alert.
Stay alert. Well, so this is still the Isle of Hundvik. We're at the shipyard that we were before.
Same as Aridin, I imagine. He will use it to open a gate between the world.
Shit. An earthquake.
We must hurry.
Okay, so that's the ship where that guy was. Holy shit. Let's go underneath. Okay, never mind. Not underneath. Where is Yennefer going? Picking up all sorts of stuff since I'm still mashing X together. Holy shit! So this is the end of the world, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome! So yeah, this didn't end with Aridin, because Avalok is using Ciri to open up a gate between worlds. Grab the horses, yes indeed! I'll grab a horse. Here we go. Supposing we need to head this way. Oh, God. Come on, Yennefer. Gain on me, please. Because I need to follow her and I don't want to go anywhere where we should. Holy shit! Cockatrices! Basilisks! Giants!
What'll happen next?
I don't know,
Gavin.
Oh, ice giants! I'm guessing we need to go that way. Towards the giant. Oh God! We don't have time to fight all of those. Look at that! Still find this an amazing scene.
What happened to them?
The White Frost!
Oh, people died.
Damn it, it'll bury us.
Wait! Javaris Tavel!
Wait, the White Frost is consuming us. Okay, so now we need to stay next to Yennefer because she has a shield similar to what Kira had the first time we faced the White Frost. So I'm gonna heal again. Okay. Oh, gold. There we go. Didn't mean to do that, Yennefer. Sorry. That's what I was wanting to do. Dead Deireadh, the final age, by the way. Oh, we can go in there. Never mind, there was treasure down there. Move it, Yennefer. More hounds. Don't want to get too close. Don't know how far the shield reaches, but I don't think it's that far. So we're getting closer. We're at the edge of the barrier.
Damn! Avalok surrounded the tower with a magic barricade.
Can you dismantle it?
Dismantle? No, I can make a tear at best. But only for a moment, because there's no...
Specifics, Yen. Will we both get through?
No! You must go alone!
Okay, then.
With Ciri.
So be it. Okay. Go, go, go. Here we go. Hopefully she will be alright.
I'm fine. Now go. And give Avalok my heartfelt regards.
We will, Yennefer. God damn it, this is awesome. And now it's silence before the storm. Well, silence during the storm, actually. Okay, new marker for some reason, if we ever wanted to go back to this place. Go to the Elven Tower. Hello, Avalok. Give Ciri back. Okay. I guess this magic barrier is done.
So unfortunate. I'd hoped you wouldn't have to witness this.
Witness what?
Where's Ciri?
Nearby. Listen.
Shut up. I've heard enough of your bullshit. Draw your weapon. Let's get this over with.
Okay. Avalok, think about what you do. Okay. Are you giving up? Think I'll spare you?
Think I'm willing to spare you?
I think you will not attack one unarmed.
That's
so sure.
Kinda true.
Foul mood.
I am not your foe. I am merely helping Cirilla.
I don't believe you. Can't. Not after all that's happened.
Will you believe me?
Yeah. Where the hell did you come from?
Avalok speaks the truth. I asked him to help me open the tower, because I aim to enter it.
Because, didn't think to warn me. Why would you do that?
Why the hell would you do this? The Wild Hunt's been defeated.
The White Frost has not.
That's correct, as we've seen. But is that something we can defeat?
I have seen worlds bound in ice. I know what awaits you.
Only yeah, we've seen that too.
Only I can stop the White Frost. Only I can stop it.
Okay. And what do you need to do for that? Because, I don't think you have to make that sacrifice.
You don't have to make this sacrifice.
You're wrong. The White Frost is inevitable. It will come to freeze the worlds one after the other, eradicating all life. Only I can stop the destruction. I've given it much thought and made my decision.
Will you be able to get back?
What can you know about saving the world, silly? You're but a witcher.
You're too, by the way. One with more fancy abilities, but...
You must let me finish telling it.
You will, Ciri. You will. There's not much we can do right now. Except wishing her good luck.
Good luck, Ciri.
Because any of the decisions we now make don't really have a bearing on the ending.
Perhaps I should have told you. I see now you might have understood.
Know you better than you think. Don't keep me waiting.
Goodbye, Ciri. And now I'm fucking crying again. God damn it. How are you gonna stop that? There's the source. And there's our decisions. So all five of them. As I mentioned before. And as the last one. Letting her join the sorceresses on her own. Every positive decision has been made. We can't do better than that. So Ciri now has the strength to move on because of her good memories. And that's what decides whether she survives or not. Portal closes. A white orchard, so we're back where we started. We didn't see Ciri get out of the portal, so we're still guessing to what happened right now. And there's Geralt at least, and Yennefer.
I might believe you if you showed me a pair of monogrammed Batiste Galagaskins.
More likely, you just say I stole them.
Dimwits.
Well, the dimwits you like, at least. So we're back at the inn where we slaughtered a few people, by the way.
I was. Fine.
Where will you meet?
Near the Huntsman's Cottage.
Okay.
Old man always had a soft spot for me. He could sense I was a family man. A man of peace. Good nature, like himself. Would have never crossed his mind to disown me if it wasn't for that hag I call my sister.
What's her name again? Count Julian Alfonso de Witt?
Viscount Julian Alfred Pancrat Stilettenhove.
Seriously?
Don't believe me? Just watch. You'll wipe that doubting leer off your face when we go visit my estates.
Yeah, that sounds hilarious. So, this quest is the epilogue to the story. So we've done all we can. The ending has run its course. And while this is, the epilogue is always different depending on which ending you got.
Cold.
And, okay.
Bloody hell! Ow! Plowing ear pits! Help me!
So, we have a tiny quest here. So we're gonna catch the runaway horse. I don't know why we're overburdened, by the way. Because I think that's the same bug again. Maybe if I drop something. There we go. Yeah, there we go. Okay. So that's the same bug because we lost Roach for the moment. So this epilogue is always different, depending on which ending you get. And right now, we'll catch that horse first. There we go.
I think the nag would know me after all these years. They're smart. Grow attached, a bit like people. Saw officers weep for their fallen mounts, though wailing women and crying babes didn't move them one bit.
So yeah, which side were you on?
Which side you fight for?
Like most, my own. Fought to stay alive. Dying's all the same. Dirt and shite, be it under the Redanian eagle or the Imperial sun. No glory in it.
That's true. Can see the horses in good hands.
See the horses in good hands.
The best. His owners. Do you miss me, Golden? Huh? Do you miss me?
I'd say he did. Bolted off as soon as he sensed you. Toppled anyone in his way.
Do you mark anyone calling after him? Ploughing in armpits or some such?
Man, yes, indeed.
This is so odd. My neighbour, Mirko, gave him Golden to care for when I left. Want to go see him, must be worried.
Yes, indeed.
Here. Token of my appreciation for running after Golden to see he was all right.
You're welcome, man. You're welcome. So this is also actually the only epilogue that has a little side quest like that, Faithful Friend. So that's something you saw right now as well. What the hell did you do? You farted. So it's winter right now, so that's also a very nice change of scenery. And the quest right now is always called Something Ends, Something Begins, but depending on what ending you got, this will be something completely different.
Out on a hunt, Master Witcher? Thought you'd clear the area of beasts your last time through.
Rabbit hunting this time around.
Ah, so that's it. Maybe you come round, visit us this eventide. Verka's baking a pie.
We might,
don't
yeah.
Know if.
As you will. You're always welcome.
Thanks, man. Glad to see the people of White Orchard still appreciate my work. So let's go talk to the hunter, because we're meeting someone to go rabbit hunting, apparently.
Red Hellraiser.
So if you remember, we talked to this hunter, Mislav, when we did the quest for the griffin. Hello, Mislav.
She's gone.
Mad she had to wait.
No, eager to roam the fields. Prepared the cover scents and oiled the jaw traps all by herself.
Make a good hunter, wouldn't she?
Nah, too impatient, that one. Probably snatching rabbits barehanded, putting them in the traps because they're too slow to step in themselves.
Where'd she That's go?
Not far.
Sounds like Ciri, of course, so...
Farewell.
They don't waste any time telling us... Well, they hinted at it a bit, but Ciri is, of course, still alive because we had all the positive choices. Maybe I'll talk a bit about that. If you had at least 3 out of 5 positive choices, Ciri will be alive, and depending on who still rules the land, you'll get another distinction between the versions where she's alive. So right now, we have the hunting quest, but we could have also gotten the sword fetching quest, to which Ciri then... we give Ciri her new sword, in which she becomes a witcher, but this is something else. Because, as you remember, we killed Radovid, Dijkstra as well. So, Nilfgaard won the war for now.
Nothing. Just sitting, waiting for you. It's nice here.
Yes, it is. Look at that.
Wait till you see Dol Blathanna in winter, and the Blue Mountains. We'll head east soon as the snow melts. Think we might have settled in a bit too much.
You promised to show me that griffin's nest before we left. Let's go now.
Okay. Really interested?
You actually interested?
Absolutely. You said it yourself. A royal griffin's a rare sight.
Not that rare. Venture to say we'll have to slay a couple more before we get back to Kaer Morhen. But if you want to see the nest, it's just up the hill.
Come.
We will. We will. Okay. So we are gonna go to the griffin nests that we've been through before, where the, I think it was the female one that was killed there, and we had to kill the male.
To train today.
Uh-huh.
Tomorrow at sunup then. Work you hard like I did in the good old days. Probably been a while since anyone showed you just how much you still have to learn.
And clearly, Ciri has a lot on her mind, because she's not...
Almost there.
She's not really here with her head. Okay, there we go. So this is where the griffin... There's still blood here, so that's a bit weird.
Careful
since
now.
The snow would have covered
there's
all
no
that.
There's no time for you to lecture me.
Ciri, wait. There's something in there.
We really don't need to play hare and
Ciri. Forktail! Forktail! Take down the forktail! Well, two witches are gonna take this forktail down really fast. There we go. Can I loot it? Couldn't really loot it completely, but... I should remember to just press square.
Faster. That's all it needed to be to rip your shoulder wide open.
But it wasn't, and it didn't. We killed it. What is this about?
You're take angry. It easy. Unload,
but be that careless, and next time.
Don't you understand? There won't be a next time.
No, there won't be.
Ciri, what are you talking about?
I'm sorry, it's just... it's not a good time.
Wanna head back?
She's keeping enough. Something from us, but...
let's go fishing.
You can also guess what it is. So let's further loot the forktail for a second, because I'm gonna need that. There we go. So let's go to the lake. And if there's no conversation in between, I'll see you guys in a second. Okay. That was graceful.
I'll be
there
damned.
We go.
Should we
a
go?
Bear.
No, no way. Lake's gotta be full of perch, bream, or pollard. Fresh pollard. Would you like that?
I wouldn't mind some, but do we plan to wait here until he leaves?
No. We'll scare him off.
How?
Can we scare off
a
bear?
I'll improvise. Wait here.
I'll improvise. Throw a bomb to scare off the bear. That's not really improvising. Fiery explosion. That sounds about right. Right? So let's put it on his ass.
Come on, show you something.
We're gonna throw a bomb in the hole in the ice. That is awesome. So let's do it like this.
The old witcher's trick for tough winters. Not terribly subtle, but
effective. And remember, the fish comes sprouting out.
Why show it to me at all then?
Just in case. Never know what could happen on the path. What could save your life?
Okay, there we go. Collect all the fish. All and right, go for a walk with Ciri.
Who taught you that?
Vesemir. A long time ago.
Long.
Very. Back when I wanted to call myself Geralt Roger Eric Duot Pelagarcy.
What?
Tell you about it tonight.
And about the time you broke your leg after wagering you'd jump off the roof of Caer Morhen and land a horse's back.
How do you even know about that?
Eskil told me. But I want to hear you tell it. I'm certain you have a rational explanation.
I don't think he has, but anything else you want to tell me during our walk? There we go.
You never gave me piggyback rides at Caer Morhen, remember? Vesemir was the only one willing.
Well, you want one now? If I get the option, I'm gonna do that. Oh, there's swords on my back.
Had to wait till now to remind me. You've put on some weight since Caer Morhen.
Look at that. If you're gonna keep spinning around like that, you're gonna fall. Yeah, there we go. And then the cold realization sets in again.
We should get back.
So we're still walking.
Remember me training on the pendulum? How I feared I'd never manage. Yet you forbade me from giving up. I was black and blue practically all the time. That pendulum was a nightmare.
How could I forget?
Those months at Caer Morhen, they passed so quickly. I wish we'd spent more time together then.
Because this is starting to sound an awful lot like a goodbye, isn't it? A farewell. You might already know what that's about, as you can see over there. Ciri is reluctant to go towards her fate.
Almost managed to forget it was today.
Yes, indeed.
They're here for me, Geralt.
I'm going to Nilfgaard, to Ymir. I know you didn't expect this, but in Vizima, my father and I spoke for long. Argued, really, and parted. Then a messenger came with a letter. I didn't say anything at first because I wasn't sure, and then I realized I had to stop fleeing. I realized that if I wish to change anything, I cannot do so hunting monsters round forgotten villages. I must do so from there, from Nilfgaard.
Logical. You make this choice on your own?
You make this choice on your own?
If you mean to suggest Yennefer had anything to do with this, then the answer is no.
Great. Okay. She even know?
No. And I'd prefer she not get involved this time.
Sounds like a plan.
Tell her that.
This is what you want?
Is this what you want?
Yes. You're not trying to stop me. Take me to the Blue Mountains by force.
Why would we want to do that?
The world to find you, but I never intended to force anything on you.
I know.
You'll be fine. You're a witcher.
We needn't say goodbye.
No, that's true. Of course not.
Of course we don't.
I don't know when we'll see each other again.
You know where to find me.
You can't possibly stay at Kaer Morhen all the time.
Makes no difference. You'll find me.
And you can teleport, so...
True.
Remember what I taught you. Never know. Could be useful there, too.
God damn it. Crying again. Goodbye, Siri. And they say witches don't have emotions. Goodbye, Empress. There she goes. Goodbye, Siri. Goodbye. I like to think they see each other often. She can't teleport, so why not? And that's it. That was the main storyline in The Witcher. The Tree Wild Hunt, ran the gauntlet,
the invader from the south achieved,
and walked the path. We completed the game on that march.
Tactical genius.
So I'll let this play out as well.
Could not withstand Ymir's countless legions.
So Nilfgaardians, the Nilfgaard won.
Novigrad and all Redania. Weary of rebel raids, Ymir Var-Emrys conceded, restoring Temeria as a realm in liege to the Empire. When the guerrillas laid down their arms, the Emperor shifted his forces to other fronts. Through Nilfgaard's victory, Temerians got their country back, and history once again proved a consummate trickster.
So I think this is one of the better ways that could end.
Having dealt with Radovid, Ymir of Var-Emrys did the same with enemies domestic. The Emperor's loyal spies named all who had conspired against him, traitors, soldiers, and aristocrats alike. Though their mutiny had only been a murky plan, the Emperor showed no mercy, as was his wont. While the continent bled engulfed by war, Skellige bloomed under Ceres's enlightened rule. Unlike those who had come before her, the young queen did not raid foreign shores, looking instead to her people, tending to her land. The island-bound nation prospered, though its fangs of yore were dulled.
Another positive ending.
After years in exile, Ciri returned to Nilfgaard, her paternal home, where Emir prepared to name her his successor. The woman had the necessary qualities. From her father, she'd inherited an empress's political instincts. From Geralt, she had gained a sense of simple human decency. Few monarchs boast both traits, which is quite a shame.
Yes, indeed.
While monarchs moved borders and populations, Geralt and Yennefer lived a calm, quiet life, far from all things political. They breakfasted well afternoon, more often than not in bed, and passed the days on lazy strolls and long conversations.
And on the stuffed unicorn
boring,
in the background.
You say? Perhaps. But both had sought this more than anything else.
Yes, they did. So that's the end of all storylines. I think we made all the positive decisions we could. Well, in my mind at least. It's of course my way of ending this series. Hope you guys enjoyed it. We're not done yet, of course. There's still a lot of side quests we can do. But in the next episode, we're going to start off with Hearts of Stone, which should prove quite the challenge as well. So I might let this run out the animated, credits. You guys enjoyed that as well. If you enjoyed the episode, by the way, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And we're not going to stop it right here, of course. We're going to keep going in The Witcher. So see you guys in the next episode, which will be the start of Hearts of Stone. Thank you guys enormously for watching, and goodbye.